Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I haven't posted any videos in a while. As you know, I live in Ukraine and here we have great problems with electricity supply now. Constantly failing in the battlefield, Russia tries to destroy our civilian infrastructure. So stand with Ukraine, cause we are fighting with real terrorists threatening not only Ukraine but many other peaceful countries. Today I'd like to start a new project. I want to create a robotic simulator in Unreal Engine. And I want to connect it to ROS. Why do I need that? Because in Unreal Engine we can create awesome photorealistic robotic environments, which is very good for robot training using deep learning. This project will be divided into several parts. In today's video I want to test if it is possible to create physically realistic multi-body system like robotic arm in Unreal Engine. Alright, let's get started. But first I'd like to thank my patron Anthony. Thank you very much for your support. Also, I'd like to remind you, don't forget to subscribe and press like if you like the video. Let's create blank C++ project. And they call it Robotic Arm Simulator. Downloaded some free assets from Epic Store, which I'm going to use to create industrial environments for my robotic simulator. For instance, I'll definitely need this table to place my robotic arm on it. Alright, that's all good, but now I'm going to delete all these objects and I'm going to create our first test environment from scratch using built-in Unreal Editor capabilities. Let's place a cube inside our world. It will serve as outer walls for the environment I'm going to build. I'll place it at the center of the world, resize it properly. I'll just make this cube to be the size of the industrial building that I want to create. Next, I'll call this cube walls. Duplicate it. Make one of the cubes a little bit bigger. Subtract smaller cubes from the bigger one. And here's what we've got. Sort of a shell. Using the same procedure of subtracting one cube from another, I'll create some windows. Now let's add some textures. I'll use some materials from starter content. And finally, let's place the table for our robotic arm. Alright, that's it with interior creation for now. Let's move on to the most interesting part. Let's create the robot. First, I'm going to create a new blueprint class for our robot. Thank you. call it BP Robot and double click to open the editor. I've already imported 3D models of the links of my robot, so let's start assembling it. First goes the base link. By the way, I'm going to use Word.dev file as a manual for the robot assembly. Now we can place our robot inside the scene. Okay, let's attach link 2 to the base link. And from URDF file I can figure out where exactly to attach it. Now we will add physics constraint component to our robot, and I'll call it joint 1. I'll place it at the point of link 2 and attachment. All linear limits should be left disabled. And we will disable angular movements about all axes except Z. Now as you can see, link 2 is free to rotate only about Z axis relative to the base link. Now we should specify names of the constraint links. First goes child link, which is link 2. Then parent link, base link. Alright, this is our robot. Proceed with the assembly. Now I'm going to add next link. CJ is basically the same. Let's play the level and see what we've got. Oops, looks like I forgot to specify constraint links. Let's fix it quickly. One more time. It looks like link 3 is perfectly balanced, so it doesn't fall. Let's now take a look at how to move the links of the robot. For movement, I'm going to use angular motor property of the physics constraint component. We need to enable angular motor by setting angular drive mode to twist and swing. You can specify target orientation for the motor or target velocity. Let's see now how velocity drive mode works. First, I'll disable orientation drive mode. And enable velocity. Angular velocity is measured in turns by second. Alright, I like how it works. So I'm going to use velocity to control motors of the joints. Before continuing with robot assembly, I want to write a simple PID control. I want to check if it is possible to control robot joints positions in velocity mode. And here's what I've got. I set targets for joint 1 and joint 2 minus 90 and 90 degrees respectively. And now 90 and 45. Looks like my simple PID controller works. Let's continue with the assembly. And here's the final result. Now I can try to command different joints configurations. Looks like I need to work on tuning the controller gains a little bit so that it worked more smoothly. Alright, that's it for today. Pretty happy with the result. In the next videos I'll continue developing this project. Or leave your comments under the video. And don't forget to press like and subscribe. See you next time.